everything you want in Macbeth, plus a little extra cool stuff because it's live theater.
But I think we do some really interesting things design-wise and stylistically that kind of keep people on their toes.
I have an original suite of bagpipe tunes that have been written for the show.
There's fights.
Fights in the show are incredible.
And stabbings.
You know, we were so lucky to have Nick Harrison come in and choreograph some fights for us.
We did try to really go for the world of 12th century Scotland.
We're in an age where it's like you can't see a Shakespeare play or movie without it being set in space. Changing the location and the time goes to show how universal these themes are, but you don't have to do that in order to be modern.
I wouldn't say realistic necessarily, because it is a very stylized presentation of the play.
This show kind of takes Macbeth as an individual and warps it to incorporate other parts of the story, other facets of the original play.
The witches are a personification of ambition, and so they are drawn to Macbeth at the beginning when he gets all of his power. And they start planting thoughts in his head. So every time Macbeth has a soliloquy in which he says, I want to be king, or that's a step that I must o'erleap, the witches actually say that line.
Be all and the end all here, but here upon this bank and shoal of time, we jump the life to come.
But in these cases, we still have judgment here.
And then gradually, they become less and less prominent in his head because ambition has taken over his whole body at that point.
It really blurs the line between the parts of humans that we can control and the parts that we can't, especially when it comes to things like ambition and power.
There's certainly more than a few people who are completely consumed by ambition in today's society. I,